Hello everyone, welcome to Vishesh Educational Videos. In this video, I am explaining shearing and reflection. So both shearing and reflections are 2D transformations. If you are not subscribed to my channel, please subscribe to my channel. To get the notification of my new videos, please click the bell icon. So let me begin the explanation of 2D transformations, shearing and reflection. So first I'll start with the explanation of shearing. Shearing is nothing but it is skewing an object. So shearing is used to skew an object. So what is skewing then? Skewing is a transformation that distorts the shape of an object. Right? It distorts the shape of an object such that the transformed shape appears as if the object were composed of internal layers. Right guys? So shearing is nothing but a skewing of an object. So here my object may be anything. For example, triangle, rectangle, polygon, pentagon, hexagon. So my object may be anything. So shearing means I'm going to skew my object. So skewing, what it does means it distorts the shape of an object. So in such a way that the transformed shape appears as if the object were composed of internal layers. So once I take the example, once I see that, so you will understand what is actually a shearing. So internal layers will be composed of internal layers. So that has been caused to slide over each other. The internal layers will be in such a way that, they have been caused to slide over each other. So this is called shearing. So once I take the example, you can see that how my object will be skewed, right? Shearing is nothing but a skewing of an object. Now, in shearing, there are two types, X shear and Y shear. So for calculating the X shear, the formula is X dash is equal to S plus SHX into Y, Y dash is equal to Y. To calculate the Y shear, X shear means shearing with respect to X axis. Y shear means what? Shearing with respect to Y axis. So shearing with respect to Y axis is what? X dash is equal to X, Y dash is equal to Y plus SHY into X. So here SHX is the shearing factor with respect to X. Here SHY is the shearing factor with respect to Y. That means shearing factor tells how much shearing has to be done with respect to X axis or with respect to Y axis. Now, so to shear my object, I'm considering my object square here. So the coordinates for my object square is 0, 0. You can see this is the point, and 2, 0. So 2, 0, 0, 2, right? 0, 2. 2, 2. So these are my coordinates of my object square. So first I will explain the shearing with respect to X axis, right? So what is my shearing factor here? So that is SHX is equal to 2, because now I am doing shearing with respect to X axis, that's why. So now I will substitute the coordinate values to the formula, X shear formula. So what is the X shear formula here? X dash is equal to X plus SHX into Y, Y dash is equal to Y, right? So for that formula, I'm going to substitute the coordinate values. So what is the shearing factor with respect to X here? 2. Now I will explain the problem here, see here. So what is the first coordinate value I'm considering here? That is 0, 0, you know that. 0, 0 I'm considering. So what is the formula? You know that. So shearing factor, you know that is 2. So I will substitute to this formula, x dash is equal to X plus SHX into Y. That is, what is the value of X here? You can see 0 plus SHX value is what? 2 into Y value is what? 0. You can see. So 0 plus 0 is equal to what? 0. So X dash is what? 0 here for 0, 0. And Y dash is equal to Y, that is Y dash is equal to 0, because Y value is 0. So For 0 comma 0, what is the new coordinate value? The new coordinate value is also 0 comma 0. X dash is also 0, y dash is also 0. That's why the new coordinate value for 0 comma 0 is 0 comma 0 only. Now, what is the next coordinate I'm going to consider? Here I'm considering 2 comma 0. See. So 2 comma 0. Next I'll consider. I will substitute 2 comma 0 in the formula. X dash is equal to, what is the x value? 2. You can see. Plus SHX, what is the SHX value? 2 into, what is the y value? You know that 0 only, but because x is 2, y is 0, so 0, 2 into 0. So x dash is equal to us, 2 plus 2 into 0, 2 plus 0 will be 2 only. Y dash is equal to y, now what is the y in this case? That is 0. X is 2, y is 0, that's why y dash is equal to 0. Now what is the new coordinate value? 2 comma 0. So here also the coordinate value is 2 comma 0. New coordinate value is also same. Next, so I'll consider 0 comma 2. This is my coordinate 0 comma 2. So what is the x value? 0. Y value is what? 2. So we'll substitute x dash is equal to x value is what? 0 plus ceiling factor, you know that 2 into y value is what? 2 only. You can see y value is 2. So what is the value? 0 plus 4 is equal to 4 only. Now x value is changed to 4. Now what is the y dash? Y dash is equal to y. What is the y in the coordinate 0 comma 2? 2 is the y. That's why y dash is equal to 2. So what is the new coordinate value? 4 comma 2. It is very simple, guys. Suppose if you have any doubts, please post your doubts in the comment section. Right? Now last point I will consider, that is 2 comma 2. Here x is 2, y is 2. I'll substitute x value 2, x dash is equal to, what is the x value? 2 plus, what is the sx value? 2, what is the y value? Into 2, that's why 2 plus 2 into 2, that is 2 plus 4 will be 6, so x dash value will be 6. Now what is the y value here? 2 only. Y dash is equal to y, that's why y dash is equal to 2, because x is 2, y is 2. Now what are the new points here? 6 and 2. So my new coordinate value is 6 comma 2. So the old coordinates are what? 0 comma 0, 2 comma 0, 0 comma 2 and 2 comma 2. My new coordinates values are 0 comma 0, 2 comma 0, 4 comma 2 and 6 comma 2. I need to plot this. See, 0 comma 0, this is the point. Now 2 comma 0, this is the point. 4 comma 2, so 4 comma 2, see, this is the point. 6 comma 2, see, 6 comma 2, this is the point. So once you join these coordinates, you will get this figure. You can see, you can observe here, your object is skewed with respect to x-axis here. So earlier your object was like this, it was a square, it was like this. After skewing, you can see the change in your object. It is skewed, right? Now, so this is with respect to x-axis, skewing with respect to x-axis. Now we will consider skewing with respect to y-axis. See, what is the formula for skewing with respect to y-axis? That is shearing with respect to y-axis. X dash is equal to x, y dash is equal to y plus shy into x. This is the formula. So my skewing factor with respect to y-axis is what? Shy is equal to 2. Here also I am considering the skewing factor as 2, right? So first I will consider coordinate value 0 comma 0. This was the old coordinate, you know that. So for the old coordinates only I am applying, but not x shearing. I am applying y shearing here. So 0 comma 0. So what is the value of x here? 0. Y here, what is the value of y? 0. So I will substitute y dash is equal to 0 plus shy is 2 into x value is 0. That, what is the value now? What is the value of y dash? 0 only. 0 plus 0 will be 0. Now x dash is equal to x. So what is the value of x? 0. So x dash is equal to 0. Now the new coordinates values are also 0 comma 0. Now the next one is, what is the 2 comma 0? You can see, right? So 2 comma 0. So I will substitute the formula 2 comma 0. X is 2, y is 0. Y dash is equal to 0 plus 2 into 2. That is 0 plus 4. What is the value of y dash now? 4. Now what is the value of x dash? X dash is equal to x. Here what is the value of x? That is 2. Sorry. Here the what is the value of x? That is 2. That is why x dash is equal to 2. So y dash is equal to 4. X dash is equal to 2. So what is the value? 2 comma 4. Earlier it was 2 comma 0. The new coordinate value is what? 2 comma 4. Now for the third coordinates. So 0 comma 2. So I will substitute y dash is equal to 2 plus 2 into 0. 2 into 0 will be 0. So 2 plus 0 will be 2 only. So y dash is equal to 2. So what is the x dash value? You can see x value is 0 in 0 comma 2. That's why x dash is equal to 0. X dash is equal to x. That's why x dash is equal to 0, because x value is 0. So what is the new coordinate value? What is the new coordinate value? That is 0 comma 2. That is x dash is 0, y dash is 2. You can see the new coordinate value is 0 comma 2 only, right? So next, last vertice, that is 2 comma 2. You can see, right? So 2 comma 2, I will substitute the value. Y dash is equal to 2 plus 2 into 2. That is 2 plus 4. 2 plus 4 will be 6. That is the y dash value for 2 comma 2. What is the x dash value? What is the formula for x dash? X dash is equal to x. Here what is the value of x? 2. So x dash is equal to 2. So what are the values now? 2 comma 6. So old values are 2 comma 2. The new coordinate values are what? 2 comma 6. So once I plot the right, once I plot the diagram, you can see here the object is skewed. So originally it was like this. It was a square. When you skew with respect to x axis, it skewed like this. Now when you skewed with respect to y axis, you can see here it is skewed like this. Getting, guys? So this is skewing. So right, skewing or shearing, one and the same. Shearing means you are going to skew the object. So you can skew your object with respect to x axis, or you can skew your object with respect to y axis. So both the cases we have seen both the cases now, right? Now I'll continue with the reflection. This is also another type of 2D transformation. So reflection means you have rotating the image 180 degrees. That means you have to rotate your image 180 degrees. So in other words, reflection can be also called as mirror image. Right, a transformation that produces a mirror image of an object is also called as a reflection. So reflection is nothing but rotating the image 180 degrees. In the same way, reflection is also called as a transformation that produces a mirror image of an object. So mirror image of an object will be produced. That means 180 degrees. Rotating your object in 180 degrees. So that is reflection. So in reflection, how many cases? There are 3 cases in reflection. You can produce reflection with respect to x axis, you can produce reflection with respect to y axis, and you can produce reflection with respect to origin. You can write. So this is with respect to origin. These are the 3 cases: x axis, y axis and origin. Now we will see the 3 cases in detail. Now see, so for a reflection with respect to x axis, the formula is this. Here for the reflection with respect to x-axis, I am considering a homogeneous coordinates here. So you can see here h is nothing but a homogeneous coordinate here. X dash, y dash is the new coordinate values. X, y is nothing but the old coordinate values. To find out the reflection with respect to x-axis, this is the formula. Right? Now, so to explain the reflection with respect to x-axis, I am plotting a triangle here. 2 comma 2 coordinates for this triangle is 2 comma 2. Next 3 comma 4 and 4 comma 2. So 3 comma 4. So 3 comma 4 and 4 comma 2. So you can see here this is the triangle. Now I have to apply the formula, this formula for each coordinates, then I will get the reflection with respect to x-axis. So I will apply the formula. Now I have to substitute the coordinate values 2 comma 2. You can see 2 comma 2. I have substitute the values. So you can see here x's value is 2, y value is 2, homogeneous coordinate value is 1. Because you know that if you know more about, if you want to know more about homogeneous coordinates, you can refer my video. The link is in the description. So the homogeneous coordinate value is 1. Right? So now I have to do the matrix multiplication. It is very simple. See here. So how to do a matrix multiplication? So see here. So first you have to take the first row and you have to multiply with this column. Right? See here. 1 into 2, 2. 0 into 2, 0. 0 into 1, 0. So what is the first value you got? 1 into 2, 2. Now 0 into 2, 0. Minus 1 into 2, minus 2. 0 into 1, 0. So what is the value we got? Minus 2. So lastly, 0 into 2, 0. 0 into 2, 0. So 1 into 1, 1. So what is the value we got? 1. So after doing the matrix multiplication, after multiplying the row with the column, so right rows with the column, what we got? 2 comma minus 2 comma 1. So here you can neglect the 1 because it is a homogeneous coordinate. So that's why you can neglect this one. You can consider only two coordinate values, that is 2 comma minus 2. So my new coordinate value is what? 2 comma minus 2. So earlier what was the value? 2 comma 2. But after substituting the values, what I got? 2 comma minus 2. Now, so I have to substitute next vertices, next coordinate values to the formula, that is 3 comma 4. Sorry. So you can see here. So I'm substituting 3 comma 4 in the formula. So after doing the matrix multiplication, so what are the values we got? 3 comma minus 4 comma 1. It is very simple. You know that how I got this matrix multiplication. 1 into 3, 0 into 4, 0 into 1, 0. So 1 into 3 only will be there. That's why the value is 3. So next row, so 0 into 3, 0. Minus 1 into 4, minus 4, 1 into 1. 1 into 1 is what? 1 only. So 4 into 1 is what? Sorry, minus 4 into 1 is what? Getting guys? Minus, sorry, see. Minus 4 into 1 is what? Minus 4 only. That's why the value will be minus 4. Lastly, 0 into 3, 0. 0 into 4, 0. 1 into 1, 1 only. Getting guys? So here I got 3. Here I got minus 4. And here I got 1. So I told you already, you can neglect the homogeneous coordinate. So what is the value of the new coordinate? 3 comma minus 4. So I got 3 comma minus 4. So earlier old value was 3 comma 4. Now I'll substitute, right? So 4 comma 2. So what is that third coordinates? 4 comma 2. So once I substitute the 4 comma 2 value, you can see the new coordinate value will be 4 comma minus 2. You know that how to do that. So what are the coordinate values I got? New coordinate values: 2 comma minus 2, 3 comma minus 4, 4 comma minus 2. If you have any doubts, please post your doubts in the comment section. So I have to plot. So if I plot the triangle, now you can see here. So this is the reflection of the original triangle, that is, it is rotated 180 degrees. See, earlier it was like this, now it is rotated 180 degrees. So this is the reflection with respect to x-axis. So this is the formula, this is the formula for that. Getting guys? Now I will reflect with respect to y-axis. So formula is this one. So what is the difference in this? Here 1 0 0 0 minus 1 0 0 0 1 was there. Here minus 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1. Here you are changing the value to minus 1. Here you are removing the minus 1. So it's a simple change. Now this is the formula for y axis. Now the coordinate value, you know that 2 comma 2, 3 comma 4, 4 comma 2 only. So these are the old values. Now I have to apply this to the formula to get the reflection with respect to y axis. So directly I have written here, you know that the steps are very simple, right? So in the previous slides I have shown the steps, right? The same thing you have to apply here also, you will get the values. So what are the new coordinate values here? So according to this formula, minus 2 comma 2, for 2 comma 2 the new coordinate value what you will get is minus 2 comma 2, because here you can see when you do matrix multiplication, minus 1 is there here, that's why minus 2 here, 1 is there, that's why 2 here. Homogeneous coordinates I already told you, you can neglect it. So for 2 comma 2 you will get minus 2 comma 2, for 3 comma 4 you will get minus 3 comma 4. Directly I have written this, right? So you can do a matrix multiplication, you will get this value, it is very easy, right? So 4 comma 2, what you will get? Minus 4 comma 2. So when you plot the graph, you will get a triangle like this. So you can see here, this is the reflection with respect to y axis. It rotated the triangle. So earlier it was like this. Now after rotating with respect to y axis, so you are getting the triangle here. So this is the mirror image with respect to y axis, reflection with respect to y axis. Now what is the last case? So you have to reflect with respect to origin. So this is the formula here. Here also I made a simple change, that is I introduced minus 1 here, minus 1 and minus 1, both are minus 1 only, right? So I introduced minus 1 and minus 1. So now I have to substitute these old values to get the new values, you know that. So 2 comma 2, so for 2 comma 2 what is the new coordinate value you will get? So obviously minus 1 is there. So this value, homogeneous coordinate value, you have to neglect, you know that. So when you multiply 2 comma 2 and 2 with minus 1 and minus 1, you will get minus 2. So this is for first minus 2, this is for second minus 2, you know that. So 2 comma 2 will be minus 2 comma minus 2. Next 3 comma 4 will be obviously same thing, minus 3 and minus 4. So minus 3 minus 4, so 4 comma 2, so it will be minus 4 comma minus 2. So when you plot this, you can see you got the triangle here. So here you rotated the triangle with respect to origin. See here, origin, right? So here you rotated the triangle with respect to origin. So this is the formula. So if you plot this, you got the triangle. See, this was the original position. When you rotated with respect to origin, this is the place where you get the triangle. Getting, guys? So hope you understood the concept. If you have any doubts, please post your doubts in the comment section. Thank you for watching the video.